Architectural blocks can be created for groups of items. When these objects are blocked together, they will move and copy as a single object. And you can add these architectural blocks to your library for future use. There are a few items that you cannot include in architectural blocks, such as walls, text, cameras, and a few other items. Let's take a look at how to create and save architectural blocks. In the sample plan that I have open, in the center of the living room are a collection of furniture items, sofas, chairs, rug, coffee table, and a few other accessories. I'd like to create a block for this furniture grouping and save it to my library so I can use it for future plans. It's also a convenient way to be able to move this item around for space planning. To create an architectural block, I'm going to use my mouse and I'm going to use the left mouse button and click and drag a marquee around those objects. In my lower edit menu, you'll notice that there are 11 objects selected in my status bar, and just above that is the option to create an architectural block. Once I've created a block, I can now move this grouping around wherever I need to in my plan. You can also double click and open up the architectural block specification. If you plan to add this architectural block to your library, you can come in here, you can control if there's a bounding box, if you want to display the sub-objects, and you can also come in here on the label panel and specify an exact label in this case, providing a good description when you want to reuse this block in the future. While this architectural block is still selected, you'll find an option to add this architectural block to your library. The architectural block will come in with an untitled description. It's a good idea just to click on this and give it a good name. Once the architectural block is added into the library, you can easily place that for your designs. I'll come over here to an area that is wide open, click and place the living room that we just blocked. I'll then press my spacebar to deselect it. Then I can click on it, hold my control key to override bumping and snapping, and then it can be positioned in any of the rooms that has enough space for that particular architectural block. Architectural blocks can be unblocked. We call that exploding the block. You'll find that option down in the lower edit menu when the architectural block is selected. When you click the explode architectural block, you now have control over each of the individual objects. And in this case, you might reconfigure the architectural block of the furniture grouping, reblock it, and save it into your library for another option for your furniture grouping. To create an architectural block for all of the items in the office, I'll left click and draw a marquee around all of the components. And you're going to notice in the lower left hand menu, there is no block option. I mentioned at the beginning of the video, some items, such as text, may not be included in an architectural block. In this case, I'll press my control key and click on the office, and now you'll notice that the architectural block tool is available, and I can now use it to create an architectural block for those office items. And once this is an architectural block, you can add it into your library. You can unblock it, and of course you can move this as a single object around your design and position it wherever you need to. Now the next component that I want to show you how to create a block for is the kitchen island. Depending on the location and the type of items you're creating for your architectural block, it may be difficult to select all of the items. In this case of the kitchen island, let's go ahead and zoom in just a little bit more. You'll notice there are a variety of chairs that you can control click to grab all of the chairs. And then there's a handful of cabinets with an overhang of a kitchen counter, and you can again hold your control key down and grab these cabinets and click around them. And sometimes it's difficult to get all of them. You can also hold your left mouse button down and draw a marquee around. And again, this is a difficult selection because of the room configuration on a 45-degree angle. Go ahead and press my space bar here. One of the tools you can use is a marquee select similar. In this case, I have three different types of objects. I have a stool, I have an accessory item, and I have a kitchen cabinet. With all three of those things selected, you'll see this marquee select similar objects in your lower edit menu. Now I can use this tool and come over here and drag a marquee around the different components. This makes it easy to select the object. I can now come down and make it an architectural block. Once it's a block, it will move as a single object. I can easily move this grouping around in the design. Sometimes I like to turn off this bounding box. If you double click on the object, turn off the bounding box. You then can get a clear view in your floor plan of exactly where this architectural object will go. You can also name this object as we saw earlier if I come over and specify the label. And of course, the final thing I can do is add it into my library. And now that kitchen island is available to use in future plans. To learn more about architectural blocks, please see our help file. You can also find additional support articles available on the Home Designer Software website. And thanks for watching the video.